Hello and welcome to The Print. I'm standing here at one of South India's largest and busiest temples, the Srirangam Temple in Trichy, Tamil Nadu. It's so busy that in December 2023, a fight broke out between frustrated pilgrims who were waiting in line for darshan and the temple staff. This issue was politicized by the BJP's Annamalai, who raised an important point that the administration of this temple, as well as most large temples in Tamil Nadu, with the exception of the famous Chidambaram temple, is administered by the Hindu Religious and Charitable Endowments Department of the Tamil Nadu government. The Hindu Religious and Charitable Endowments Department was set up after the HRNCE Act was passed in Tamil Nadu in 1959 following decades of social justice reform. The history of temple administration is inextricably linked to Periyar and the Dravidian movement, which in turn has laid the foundation of contemporary Tamil politics. The angst and the anger around this boils down to this fundamental question: who gets to decide how temples are run? The HRNCE department in Tamil Nadu is on the front lines of this war. They are credited with saving temples from casteist rot, but also stand accused of mismanaging temples and disenfranchising priests. And there are some, like activist D.R. Ramesh, who have been trying to hold them accountable and keep them transparent.
If you ask me why temples should be freed out of government control, first of all, it is basic fundamental rights of citizens to manage their religious institutions, to administer their religious institutions, and to establish their religious institutions. It is a basic right given under Article 25 and 26 of the Indian Constitution. Second, what has government control of temples done to the temples? It has made 30 to 40,000 temples go out of puja in Tamil Nadu. It has made nearly 5 lakh acres of temple lands disappear. And with the current holdings of 5.25 lakh acres of agricultural lands and 29 crore square feet of sites and 22,600 buildings, the fair rent that should be collected every year should be around 6,000 crores. The government is not even collecting rupees 200 crores every year. This is a huge, huge deficit for the Dharma activities that Hindus would like to happen through their temples. This is cheating of Hindus. This is discrimination of Hindus. More reasons would be there is pathetic audit of Hindu temples by the government. 18.69 lakh audit objections are pending resolution from 1986. This is the most shameful thing. And the invaluable structural heritage, mural heritage, architectural splendor of Tamil Nadu temples, the only state that has more than 400 ancient functioning monuments that are 1,000 years old. They are being squandered, they are being vandalized in the name of modern renovations just for the sake of the politicians and the babus getting lucrative contracts, civil work contracts, where they can make huge amount of kickbacks. The heritage of the temple is given a go by. Temples should be free of government control, just like churches are, just like mosques are.
Another bone of contention that highlights the caste dynamics of this struggle is this very Periyar statue right outside the Srirangam temple. The BJP has declared that if they come to power in the state, the first thing they will do is to remove this statue. Why? Because it's Periyar declaring that there is no God. On one side is the DMK government and anti-caste activists who insist that temples should be run by the government to cleanse temples of casteism. On the other side is the Free Temples movement, which accuses the DMK government of failing to protect and govern temples and instead misusing their lands and funds. Both sides advocate for the right to manage temple resources, but neither side sees eye to eye.
This issue of mismanagement of temples and properties is a part of the BJP's agenda to gain foothold in Tamil Nadu. They have not raised this issue during AIADMK rule, especially during Jayalalitha's rule. All these issues they are taking up only after DMK comes to power. So this mismanagement of temple has no grounds. They say that HRNCE, Hindu Religious and Endowment Department, they should go out of the temples and temples should be handed over to Hindus. Who are the Hindus? who are the representatives of the Hindus. The majority of the Hindus have elected this government to be their representative. And these people who are proxies of BJP, they say they are the representatives of Hindus. In practice, they are representatives of the Brahminic authority. They want to again gain authority over the temples. It is not about properties. It's not about the wealth of the temples. It's about the spiritual dominance of Brahmins over the Hindu community. It is manifested in this appointment of archakas, non-Brahmin archakas, in Tamil Nadu temples. The DMK government appointed non-Brahmin priests in temples. They have filed scores of cases in high courts and Supreme Court to remove them. It is now stayed. Hundreds of non-Brahmins and Dalit priests, properly trained, are outside waiting for appointment. Why they are rejected? Why they are stopped? They say there are Agama Shastras, there are customs, there are usages. These Agama Shastras, customs and usages are all the copies of Sanatan Dharma or Varna Dharma or casteism, caste supremacy. They claim hereditary right over the supremacy of Hindus over Hindus as priests of the temple. If they can, as they wish, if they can capture the temples, they think they can capture the minds of Tamil people, which so far they are unable to gain. That is the main motive. That's what is pushing them to this extent.
Now, a new temple freedom movement has been gaining momentum in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Uttarakhand, Odisha, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, West Bengal. But the epicenter of this movement is Tamil Nadu, forged over 7 decades of social justice politics when the government took power away from the priests to manage the state's temples in 1959. And centuries after India's revolutionary temple entry movement, a new kind of churn is underway, helmed by the BJP. This is Vandana Menon, reporting for The Print.